Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the RabbitMQ components from within the SSIS Productivity Pack product. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. Using our RabbitMQ components, we can facilitate integration with RabbitMQ from within SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers three RabbitMQ components: RabbitMQ Connection Manager, RabbitMQ Source, and RabbitMQ Destination. The Connection Manager can be used to establish connections with RabbitMQ. The Source component can be used to read or receive data from RabbitMQ, whereas the Destination component can be used to send messages to our RabbitMQ server. Let's begin by creating our RabbitMQ Connection Manager. Right-click on the Connection Manager area down below to add a new connection. Select the RabbitMQ item to add this new Connection Manager. The host name is the name of the host where the RabbitMQ server is located. Next, specify the port used to connect to the RabbitMQ server. You can also specify the virtual host to connect to. Below are the authentication settings for username and password. There is a connection timeout setting in seconds. This is defaulted to 120 seconds. Lastly, the heartbeat setting specifies the heartbeat interval in seconds. The heartbeat feature periodically checks to see if a connection is still active. If this is set to 0, heartbeats are disabled. The SSL settings page allow you to enable and specify SSL connection settings for RabbitMQ. Server name is the name of the SSL server. You can also select the version of SSL to use from the drop-down list. Certificate specifies the path of the certificate file to use. You can also enter a certificate passphrase. The next three options under acceptable certificate errors will reduce security if they are enabled: remote certificate not available, remote certificate name mismatch, and remote certificate chain errors. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package level connection manager. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project level connection managers if you right-click the connection managers node within the Solution Explorer. Let's begin configuring our data flow task, starting with our RabbitMQ source component by dragging it to the design surface. Double-click to open its editor form. As mentioned before, the RabbitMQ source component is an SSIS data flow pipeline component that can be used to read and receive data from RabbitMQ. Let's select a RabbitMQ connection manager. You can specify the name of the exchange to receive messages from. The queue name is the name of the queue to receive messages from. There are two different modes available for receiving messages: peek and receive and delete. If the peek option is selected, messages will be received from the queue without deleting them or modifying the queue in any way. If the receive messages and delete option is selected, messages will be retrieved and deleted from the queue. It is only possible to select a listener mode if the receive mode is receive and delete. Next, you can specify a batch size to use when receiving messages. A larger batch size can improve performance. The encoding option will automatically default to the user's Windows regional settings. After the RabbitMQ component has retrieved all available messages from the queue, it can continue to listen for more messages for a period of time. There are three listener modes available. Listener modes other than none are only compatible with the receive and delete receive mode. The fixed time mode allows the component to listen for messages for a specified period of time. The wait until mode allows the component to listen for messages until a specified date and time. The wait until variable mode allows the component to listen for messages until a date and time specified in a variable. For today's demo, we will select peak as our receive mode. Navigating to the columns page, this will show a default list of properties of messages that will be retrieved. By clicking the Add button, additional columns can be added that correspond to other properties of incoming messages. Clicking the Refresh Component button causes the component to retrieve the latest metadata and update each field to its most recent metadata. It will remove any custom fields that have been added on the columns page. Let's click OK to finish configuring our source component. For this demonstration, we are going to add a dummy data reader destination component for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination components. We can now execute this task successfully. We will now demonstrate setting messages to our RabbitMQ server using the RabbitMQ Destination Component. Let's begin by generating some sample data using our Data Spawner component, which is also a part of our Productivity Pack. Let's select a RabbitMQ Connection Manager. We can also specify the exchange name, which is the name of the exchange to send messages to. The routing key is the routing key of sent messages. The delivery mode can be set to persistent or non-persistent. Persistent messages are stored on disk on the server and will persist after a server restart. Non-persistent messages are only stored in memory. Next is the priority of sent messages. The possible range is from 0 to 255. The encoding option will automatically default to the user's Windows regional settings, but you can always choose a different one as needed, depending on how the message should be encoded. Let's navigate to the columns page where we can map the columns from upstream components to destination attributes. Clicking the Add button will bring up a dialog that will allow columns to be added that correspond to custom headers on outgoing messages. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow task will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns, error code, error column, error message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. Let's click OK to finish configuring our destination component. We can now execute this task successfully. This concludes a demonstration of the RabbitMQ components from within our SSIS Productivity Pack. There are many other components in the SSIS Productivity Pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. RabbitMQ is just one of the messaging queue technologies that are supported. The Productivity Pack comes with a few other messaging queue support, including Azure Service Bus, MSMQ, IBM MQ, and etc. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.